This is the AP Physics C Centripetal Acceleration Linearizing Project by Tyler Michelson, Mario Flores, Shiv Chitre, and Stuart Wilson. Our problem in context is we are given an object mass, MS, which is attached to a string and is being spun in a circle. The string is put through a hollow tube, and at the end is a hanging mass of mass MH. The problem we're trying to prove that v squared over r is equal to a. So what we did is we derived the sum of the forces equals ma using three different velocity relationships, as seen on the slide. So what we did is we graphed v velocity versus the force. So we kept the radius constant, but the hanging masses are changed, in which the resulting velocities are noted in the table below. Next, we multiplied each of the masses by acceleration due to gravity, 9.8 meters per second, in order to yield force values. Then we linearized by taking the square root of each of the force values as shown below. Then we graphed it and then linearized it on the velocity versus force graph. The velocity is the y variable and the f is the x variable. And from this graph, we got v equals square root k times f. The second graph that we constructed is the velocity versus ms graph. The radius and hanging masses are kept constant, but the spinning masses are changed. The resulting velocities are noted. Next, we linearize by taking the square root of the inverses of each of the masses. And then we graphed it, keeping velocity as the y variable, and then we made ms, the mass of the block, as the x variable. And from this graph, we got v equals square root k2 over ms. Our third graph is v versus r. Hanging and spinning masses are kept constant, but the radii of the spinning masses are changed. The resulting velocities are noted. We linearize by taking the square root of each of the radii. And then when we graphed it, we kept velocity as the y variable on the y-axis, and then we made r be the x-axis. And so from this graph, we got the equation v equals square root k3 times r. So in conclusion, because the square root of f, the square root of 1 over ms, and the square root of r are all directly proportional to velocity, the three equations are as follows. And then from these three equations, they can be combined to produce f equals mv squared over r. And when we substitute f as ma, we can cancel out the mass variable, and what we get is a equals v squared over r.